Now let's talk about the last of the extensometers, that is the Hagenberger extensometer. Now this is used for surface measurements, and this is again an extensometer which makes use of mechanical magnification. So in this, the magnification is basically brought about by using a double lever mechanism. We make use of a double lever mechanism, okay, and the magnification is about 1000 times. So this is how, you know, good it is as compared to the previous two extensometers. Okay, now the advantage is that there is no fixed gauge length which you require for its functioning. You have a frame. On this frame you have points A and point C. So these two points A and C, they are fixed onto the frame. Okay, now this point A is basically a movable knife edge, and there is a fixed knife edge which is fixed to the frame. So this cannot move, but this can move in a vertical direction. Okay, then you have a rocker. BD is a rocker, okay, which rocks like this, and this rocking motion, or this rocker, is basically transmitting the motion from this knife edge, which can move vertically up and down. So when this moves up and down, that is the knife, this rocker will move like this. So when it moves up, it moves down. So this is how the motion is happening, and basically this rocker is transmitting this movement from the knife edge onto the pointer. So this pointer is at point D, and D is a point on the rocker. So this is how this pointer will move. Okay, and this rocker is kept in its position with the help of the spring. Right, so this is pretty much how this entire extensometer looks like and functions. So this knife edge can actually press against the surface. Okay, and if there is certain, you know, you can say disturbances in the smoothness of the surface, there will be a movement in the knife edge. Okay, and due to this movement of the knife edge, this rocker will move, and this rocker will make the pointer move, and the amount of you can say knife edge movement, or the amount of deviation from the smoothness of the surface, can be read on this scale. Okay, so this is how we make use of an Hagenberger extensometer to actually look at the variations in the smoothness of a surface. So I hope you understood this. So this is what you need to understand in extensometer topic. After this, let's move on to the electrical strain gauges.